All right, let's do this now. The reaction is still coming in tonight by the thousands and thousands, in fact, from our shocking report yesterday, where we detailed how Americans are now having to take what appears to be a loyalty oath to Israel if they want to keep their jobs. This is not an obscure law passed in one state. It's a law that's now passed, as you can see from the map behind me, a law that's now passed in 24 states. 13 more states have pending legislation on this. There's the map. It shows the states in red that we're talking about, the ones that have passed this law forcing their state workers to sign this agreement that they will not join any economic movements or boycotts against Israel if they know what's good for them, if they want to keep their jobs. Yes, I know. It sounds horribly unconstitutional. In fact, it sounds horribly un-American, doesn't it? But these laws are passing with both ferocity and unanimity in places like New York. That was the first place where it was passed. Now Texas, where a woman has lost her job because of this. The laws are called anti-BDS statutes. Among the many who seem outraged by this phenomenon is one of America's most prodigious writers and thinkers. He's a Pulitzer Prize winner who was the New York Times Middle East correspondent, once again, also part of the RT family, with his weekend show called On Contact. Here, Chris Hedges.
This is part of a massive effort on the part of the Israeli government to break the back of the boycott, divestment, and sanction movement, which has certainly grown in Europe and is growing on college campuses across the United States. It calls for the boycott of Israeli goods, divestment, and sanctions imposed on the apartheid state of Israel, until Palestinian rights are recognized and Israel ceases its violation of international law in terms of its occupation of Palestinians and Palestinian territory, including East Jerusalem. And the BDS movement, which I support, has not been particularly, it hasn't been successful at all, really, in getting college campuses to divest from Israeli companies, including those in the West Bank, which is occupied territory. But where it has been very successful is changing a public perception of Israel. And so we've seen, accompanied by this insane law, a loyalty oath is the right phrase for it, being passed in state legislatures. This is part of AIPAC and the other Israel lobby efforts, which has deep pockets, big money behind it. Sheldon Adelson, Trump's largest contributor, is the largest donor to this kind of movement. We've seen on university campuses organizations that speak up on behalf of Palestinian equality, Students for Justice in Palestine, being banned. And I think it's because Israel is no longer able to control the narrative or hide the brutality of the apartheid system that they carry out against the Palestinian people. And so they have built these bizarre alliances with the Christian right, and there's a deep core of anti-Semitism among the Christian right. They've redefined anti-Semitism. They don't really care, frankly, how Jews are treated or whether you live next to a Jew. It's if you criticize the state of Israel. And that's part of this process, that they've lost the court of public opinion, and they are trying desperately to essentially break a movement that raises consciousness quite effectively and frightens them.
You know, what's interesting about this law is that as much as we could talk all day about policies of Israel and the rights of Palestinians, this seems to be something that cuts at the core of what we are as Americans. I mean, it seems, if nothing else, extra constitutional to say to anybody living in the United States, if you want to keep your job, you have to sign a document that agrees with a certain policy, interestingly enough, not of your state, not of your country, but of another country. Doesn't that just seem just overreaching to you?
Well, completely. I mean, you just, with this Texas law, you had a, they wanted a woman who had had a contract in the public school system as a speech therapist who was of Palestinian descent to agree that she would not carry out any behavior or activities that supported the BDS movement. So she can go, she couldn't go into a supermarket and not buy Israeli produced hummus or whatever it is that they were selling, that would be grounds for termination of her contract. It's completely nuts. It's completely insane. We don't have these clauses. Public officials don't have to sign clauses promising that they won't boycott Canadian goods or Russian goods or whatever it is. Yes, it's complete overreach, but I think it's a signal or a symptom of how desperate the Israeli government has become.
Hey YouTube, thanks for checking out our channel. We hope you enjoyed the video. We have tons of content for you just like this. For more of RT America's one-of-a-kind news and analysis, be sure to subscribe and never stop questioning more.